Hello everyone, in this video I will be covering plumbing basics. If you watch until the end, I'll be covering some great tips and tricks, so stay tuned and keep watching. I'm Hassan Umer from Integrated BIM, and I have been doing a lot of step-by-step tutorials for the contemporary villa and as well as beginner tutorials, which you can see if you click on the pop-up link above or link in the description below. This video will guide you as a step-by-step tutorial how to put plumbing in a contemporary modern villa. Before we start drawing the plumbing components, let's understand a little bit more about them and how they are working. So if we go to the floor plan, and if we zoom in one of the bathrooms, we can click on the sink and we can see that there are a couple of icons listed behind the sink. If I zoom in, I can see that there are written like the diameter of the components and also an icon indicating what they are. So the cold water icon is indicating cold water system. Hot water with a red water is indicating hot water system. And this icon is indicating a sanitary system. You can go inside the family. And then in order to understand further how they are working, you need to create a geometries and then you need to assign MEP component to them and then indicate what they are. Are they in or out? In this case, if I just go on a 3D and select this icon here, I can see that this is an in and it's written domestic cold water. And I can go the other side and I can see that I'm domestic hot water. And then in the middle, the bigger radius, I can see that it is a sanitary and it says it's out. You can go back to the floor plan and you can also see where it's written in and out over here underneath it. So it's 31.8 millimeter out, meaning it will be wastewater. So let's see how they're going to work. In order to draw your MEP components, you can just simply click on the icon and a draw icon will appear automatically. It will be indicating that it will be selecting automatically that it's a cold water and the diameter based on your requirements. And you can obviously change the diameter from here the way you want. And what you can do is you can start drawing. However, you will receive a warning message like this, meaning you cannot create these pipes because you have an architectural model or you just got an architectural model and the settings are not made for the plumbing yet. Generally, the architectural templates do not have plumbing information, plumbing settings, so it will not allow you to create. And don't get worried because I will show you a couple of tricks now and you can do it in less than maybe 20 seconds. Just find another project that is an MEP project. Here I have a sample for you and open this up. Once you open it up, go back to your project, go to Manage tab, go to Transfer Project Standards, check the none, make sure that you're selecting the right project, the MEP project, and go scroll down all the way to the pipe settings. So take the pipe installation, pipe schedules, types, pipe segments, settings, sizes, and types. And if there are anything else left, you can take them as well. And you can take other MEP components if you wanted to make the settings for the ducts and other components. But for now, we are going to focus only on the pipes. Once you do that, it will transfer all the data into your project. So you can just override basically all the data. And once you override it, you can just simply go back and select pipe component or just click on the tool. And you can go from the edit type to the type properties, and from their routing preferences you can select edit and you will be able to see that here most of them listed as none. So now you have the components, you just need to populate them. So I will just go with a standard one. I will go all options. So I will go with a T if I have another tab. Okay, so I will go with a T. I will go with a standard one, all generic, all, and you can select all, and I repeat this process for all of them. And once I'm done, I'm clicking OK and OK. Now the next thing what I can do is I can simply click on the sink and click on the cold water icon. And now I can just simply start drawing and you will be able to see that something appeared and I have a warning message that saying it could not find the same pipe type. So default is just trying to match the default item. That is fine. And I can do fine in order to see how the pipe is looking, because in the medium and coarse views, I can see this is just a lines. Here I can see the 3D component, how they are looking. So maybe this view is not the best view that I can get benefit of. So I will be closing in a second the MEP part and the sink. I'm just closing all other views. What I will be showing you now is that if you want a better view, you can do a bottom plan view, but at the same time, you can go on a 3D quick section cut and you can use coins plugin. So there's a coin section plugin, which is on the add-ins and auto box. And then I can select the components that I'm looking for and I can select finish and click OK in 3D. So this is so quick and so lovely. I mean, if you have never used it, please just go ahead and use it. I have also a whole video for you showcasing the best Revit plugins. You can click on the pop-up link above in order to watch that video. I strongly recommend to watch that video because it will bring a lot of benefit and it will improve your daily routine. So now I can see both views and I can just do WT, click on WT here in the bottom right corner, you can see the shortcuts. And in order to see what I'm doing. So right now I have a pipe here, I have my wall, I can actually hide this wall, which I don't need. Now I can try to understand what's going on. Even I can go wireframe to see how the items are being modeled. So now I will go back and I want to have my pipe running like this inside the wall, but I don't want it all the way outside the wall. I want to keep it still inside the wall. Obviously this family is made in an awkward way, so I have my pipe starting in the middle of the wall. I don't recommend that workflow. I would rather suggest you start with some face and then you do your plumbing as you wish, so it's not offsetted so much. I would keep it at the face or at the face of the wall so you have it more flexibility. So coming back to the component, what I will do is I will select another, I will go to the systems and I will select another pipe and I will just snap. It will automatically snap on that. And I will make sure that I go a bit down 400, for example, and then start sketching upwards. Now, if I get some kind of issues like this, it means that it doesn't have enough space to create additional components, meaning I need to extend the length of the pipe. So I can hide the wall for a second. I can extend the length of the pipe a bit, like to 50, for example. And then now, if I go back to the pipe and if I route it downwards, it will work perfectly. Obviously, this is again due to the, I can just try to go a bit to the left and, but with the arrow keys, or, you know, I can try to find the best. I'm just striking things quickly over here. So it may not be, just don't criticize it because it's so close to the finish. I'm not interested in right now running the piping perfectly. It's instead just illustrating and giving you guidance how we can use them. And as soon as you set the height, you see how it turns it around automatically. You don't have to worry about most of the things with the MEP. That is the best part of it. So for example, if you had here some kind of a structural component or anything else, you can just run underneath. And then now if I wanted to lift it back up, I can just go ahead and say 509 and then I can lift it back up and it will go up again. So that is the best part of the MEP. And you start working with that like as you go, and it's really the best way to forward. So this was an easy video for you in order to get started with the piping. Please comment below if you want to learn more about the piping and what exactly you want to learn so we can cover in the next videos, because there are more videos coming in for the piping and many other components and more BIM related content. So if you just subscribe to our channel, you will be the first one notified as soon as we publish one of the videos. We are publishing 3 to 4 videos per week. So see you next time.